Let's take a look at the First Commandment. It says, "You shall have no other gods." And Luther's explanation is, we are to fear, love, and trust God above all things. When I would teach this either in catechism or for adult forums, two things tripped us up. One was, what do you mean other gods? We're not pagans, are we? And we would take a look at those things that draw our attention away from God and say, they might be not be idols in the sense of statues, but there are things that draw our attention away from God. But what people really got hung up on was we are to fear, love, and trust God above all things. Fear God. How can one love someone whom someone is supposed to fear? But I think we've lost something in our culture. How many of us really are in awe of anyone or anything? How many of us have a sense of dread, the definition meaning something that is awesome or awful, that fills us with awe? I think in some ways we've become so large and self-sufficient that the world has become very small. But if we stand for a moment in awe of God with some sense of trembling and expectation, we realize that we're pretty small and God is pretty huge, which makes the world a bigger place. And also, when we look at the commandments, we should not see them as rules to be followed. This is an invitation into a way of life. So in your homes, in your churches, in your catechism classes, when you read, we are to fear and love God above all else, see this as a joyful invitation to enter into the heart of God's love.